Hello everyone, welcome to Besant Technologies and I am Priya Arvudam. So today in this video, we will be looking into a complete guide of full stack development. So basically, we'll be seeing what is a full stack development and how to become a full stack developer and who is this person basically called as full stack developer and what are the steps. So we'll just see them all each step by step in this tutorial. Okay, now what is a full stack? So this is the most common word that any IT people would have come across. Suppose you're applying for any job, or maybe even if you have not applied, you could have heard of this term called as full stack developer or mon stack developer. What exactly is this full stack developer? So a person who knows end-to-end working of a website is called as a full stack developer. End-to-end working means I'm not just talking about how he understands things, how it's working. It's not only that. He will be the person who will be able to build a website from the scratch to the end of the website, as well as if there is any problem, he should be able to detect where exactly the problem is. So we'll just see them step by step. First of all, so for example, when I say he's going to understand the problem everywhere, we'll just go on with an example. So let's say a famous website called as Amazon. So we all know that it's just an online shopping market. Well, so this page, okay? This actually is a page which you can see, like there are many navigations here, and you have sign in here, and you have your carousel, so which pictures are actually moving, and you have the complete page of things. So this is basically just a look of how the page is. If at all there is any problem with this look, so that person, this full stack developer, should understand where exactly is the problem and he should sort it out. Secondly, if I'm trying to sign in or do something, and if I'm facing any problem here, even this error should be detected by the person called as full stack. He should be able to understand where the problem is and how things are working. And if I click on this computers, I should get back the results based on computers. So this logical section, which is happening in the back end, okay, which is not visible to a person, is all taken care by a full stack developer. And in addition, he should also know the database that it is connected with. So end to end, right from the look of the computer, look of the website, the backend technologies, that is the logical part, and the data accessing, which is called as database. This complete thing is known by a full stack developer. So he who has a complete knowledge on these three things of a website is called a full stack developer. Well, so with this, let's understand the different parts of it now. So when I say full stack, it means front end, back end, and then the database layer. So front end is nothing but everything that you can see on a website or on a page. Okay, this is the screen, and all the screen that I'm able to see through my eyes is my front end. So right from the coloring, right from the images, right from the icons, everything. So all this is called as your front end, which is called as presentation layer as well. So secondly, we have backend. So this basically is a logical part. So any logical things or any service, suppose I'm requesting for some service and then getting a response back. So happening of these events is called as backend, which happens in the backend, but it gives you the output or the requested response on the screen. Okay, so things that are not visible to your eyes, but happening on the screen behind is called as backend. Finally, we have database. So database, of course, storage of data and retrieved whenever needed. So all these three. So these are the three essential layers of a full stack development services. Now, let's look into each one by one. The visible part of the website is called as front end. So this front end is built up by three different languages. So what are these? First of all, to start from the scratch, it is HTML. to start a website from the scratch, we need HTML. That means to draw a skeleton or to draw an outline of your website is decided by HTML. So HTML is the one which decides what are the contents that appears on the page. Okay, so for example, let's get back to the same Amazon. So can you see we have this logo here, we have this search bar here, and we have your login settings. So forget about the working, I'm just talking about the looks, so that all of these contents are appearing that you can see on the screen is decided by HTML. Okay, so that was I was telling. And now secondly, we have CSS. So CSS is just a language which is going to do styling for your website, adding a puff color, giving the space, adding attractive effects like hovering effect, okay, whenever I move on, either the zoom in, zoom out. So all this, okay, which makes your page attractive is called a CSS part. So HTML, with the HTML, the CSS part is linked together and we form a beautiful website. So I'm just talking about the look of the website. I'm not yet talking about the working of it. Okay. So now coming back to HTML. So the current version that we are using is HTML5. So it offers many new technologies and new tags to a developer. Okay. So right from location, okay, geolocation, and then again, graphics, all this has started. It's introduced newly into HTML, and the current version of CSS that we are using now is CSS3. And secondly, JavaScript. So JavaScript, it actually lets the user to interact, okay, the interaction part. So for example, again, getting back to this Amazon website. So suppose when I click on this home and kitchen, so there is, I'm getting images or the information based on this kitchen elements. So this part where I'm able to communicate, I'm able to get an answer, okay, a response back. So this interaction is taken care by JavaScript. So altogether, when I get you here, so HTML is just a skeleton, which our whole body, everybody has a common skeleton, and CSS where a person is grown up beautifully and he's presentative, okay, to see he looks good and attractive. So that is completely the part of CSS. And then the JavaScript is either walking or sitting or running, smiling, whatever, adding life to the person. Similarly, adding life to a website is JavaScript. All right. So with all of this, to make your website even more beautiful and even more highly interactive and highly cool, so we will need few of the JavaScript website frameworks or libraries. So now I am really interested in giving you out the importance of JavaScript. So everybody would have come across JavaScript. So this is the most important scripting language that anybody should learn. Okay. So why do I call this a scripting language? By programming language. Any language that I have to compile and then do the execution part, like your C and Java, okay, that is called as your programming. And any language where I can just code and then directly go to the execution part without the compilation step, this is called a scripting language. So as I already told you, JavaScript need not be compiled. It will just be coded and it will have to go to the executing part. So if there are any bugs, so we'll have to detect it on the console part or the JavaScript engine that is available on the browser. So I can put across the definition of JavaScript like this. So JavaScript is a client-side scripting language which adds life to the web page or which enables the interaction of the website or web page, whatever. Okay. Now, JavaScript is the 75% most dominating languages across. So why? I'll tell you the reasons why it's so famous. So there are other scripting languages, so your Python. So JavaScript is even dominating Python. That's because JavaScript is very, very fast and the syntax is very easy to learn. And JavaScript has a behavior where it can combine easily with many of the other languages. So this even finds its applications in backend using Node.js.
Orange.
So JavaScript is famous. Why? Because it gets easily combined with other language. So it can be, you know, learning JavaScript, you will be able to learn front-end frameworks and libraries like Angular and React.js and all. And you can also go towards the back-end technologies like Node.js. So by learning JavaScript, it's a platform to learn both front-end as well as back-end. So this is also one of the reasons why JavaScript is leading in the market. Okay, and then moving on to the next session, we'll see the different application where JavaScript is used. So if you ask me, ma'am, where can we find JavaScript? So I'll tell you, you can find JavaScript everywhere. So right from the gaming console, you know, your mobile application, your website applications, you know, all this, even your smartwatch, smart headset, whatever it is. So everything has JavaScript and you can again rebuild it using JavaScript. Of course, with the attractive frameworks, both front-end and back-end, that is also possible. So this is all about the complete web page, like how right from starting to creating your web page, presenting it neatly, and then adding up life. So to make your program or to make your web page even more interactive, even more scalable, even more useful, we'll be using few of the frameworks. So what are those frameworks? Let's get looking at it. So we have React, Angular, and Vue.js, few of the languages that is built on JavaScript platform. So React.js is just a library. Do remember, it's a library and not a framework. Angular is a front-end framework. So even React is a front-end framework. So in today's world, there is heavy competition between React and Angular.js. And of course, always React seems to overpower Angular.js. So this is very, very useful and people across the globe like React very much compared to Angular. So of course, there are people liking Angular too, but in survey, you can just say that React is quite powerful now, okay? Now, talking about React.js. So as I already told you, it's just a library which helps you to write a neat and presentable code, okay? A highly reusable code. Why do I say React is famous and why people like it? That's because in React.js, you can basically break down all the parts of your website into components and reuse it whenever you want. So what is the advantage when I'm breaking down components? So when I'm breaking down, what actually happens is whenever there is an error in certain components, it's easy for a developer to identify what is the mistake and to rectify it. Suppose if we want to update an application, so it's easy to do that as well, because going back to only that component and changing it is going to be a very, very easy task. Secondly, React is very, very fast and you know, scalable too. So the components that you've created, you can reuse it as well. So all these three main points makes React.js in the leading place. So what is React? So when was this first introduced? So React.js, it's an open source JavaScript library, which was used and developed by Facebook. So Facebook was the first company to use or to build application using React.js and release it. And you can see it's very successful. And of late, even Instagram has been built using React.js. So we'll just see them. Let me say Facebook. So I know, I hope everybody are famous, you know, you all know what is Facebook and how things work over there, and even Instagram. So this is your image. For example, if I'll be breaking down the Facebook logo as a separate component and Facebook calling or message feed into a separate component and all the status things into separate component. So, and even the liking part and different component. Suppose if tomorrow I don't want this like button in my Facebook, and if I want to take it off, I can just go to this particular component and delete this. So I don't have to worry about the whole application because it's not going to affect it, okay? So that is the reason. So adding update to one single part of the component is easy and reloading is also easy. So there is other concept which is making this React.js even more powerful. That is called as virtual term. So you will understand this once you're getting enrolled to the classes. So when you study JavaScript, you will come across a topic called as DOM, okay? Real DOM. So React.js uses virtual DOM, wherein, you know, whenever I'm updating any state, like for the component, instead of like button, I add some other like button, or suppose I change the color of the like button, instead of white hand, I white thumbs up icon, I make it into black thumbs up icon. So if I'm changing it, it will automatically be reflected on the page. I don't have to go to the page and refresh the page and waste my time. Okay, automatically, whenever I do something, it is React, and hence the name React. Whenever there's a change, it is reacting. So this is how I can term React into. And what else? So when you have these many important properties and easier way to create your website, so it's better to use React to write your highly scalable codes. Okay, so this is all about front-end technologies. So you can just become a front-end developer learning up to React.js. Okay, so that. Now let's look into back-end technologies. So what is back-end? So I go to a Google page. Say for example, this is my Facebook. So yeah. Let me see. So for example, Facebook pages. So if I'm typing this Facebook pages, there is a fetching of, you know, services happening in the backend, and from the related server, I have all these images. Okay. So I'm setting up a request and I'm getting a response. So this is taken care by, this is where the logical part comes into picture. So when I say Facebook pages, it should give me the Facebook pages only. It shouldn't give me something else like Instagram pages or, you know, some other meaningless things. So that is also, that is the main delicate part. So relative pages, they should be, you know, relative pages should be served here. So that is the thing. So suppose the messages that I'm looking for is not in the current server. So it is in the third party server. Just imagine. So if this is the case, it is going to take time to get me the output, but still, anyway, I'll get the response. So all this process is taking behind the screen, which is not visible for a person. You only get the output or the response on the screen, not the working. So this working that's happening behind is called as backend. So moving on to backend, what are the main technologies or main languages that are into backend? So first of all, we have Node.js at the top. So few of the backend technologies goes like this: Node.js, Java, Python, PHP, .NET, and Ruby. I've given the names in the order of job openings, okay, from the higher number of job openings to lesser number of job openings, and the popularity of these languages in the market. And I mentioned the Node.js first, okay? So this is most used runtime environment on the backend technologies today. So again, Node.js is open source. When I'll have to say a technology is very successful, there would be a little causes. So main causes would be, first of all, it should be free. That means it should be open source. So Node.js is open source and it should be fast and it should be open to any type of libraries installment. So when a language has all these three aspects, so anybody will term a technology into the most easy and most useful technology. So that is how we have Node.js. So it's quite easy. So Node.js uses Express.js as its framework. Okay, just like JavaScript has React.js and Angular as its framework, Node has Express.js as its framework to run the code even more beneficially and neatly. That's the whole use of frameworks. So Node.js has a packet management called as NPG. So this NPM, sorry, so Node Package Management. So this actually allows us to install any external dependencies. Suppose I want some libraries and if I want to install it using NPM, I can easily get all those. So there is no any problem when I'll have to install any outer libraries. So you will understand this once we start into the technical part of your session. Okay. Now, putting all these together, I'll just say the definition of Node.js. So the definition of Node.js goes like this. It is a runtime environment which uses V8 JavaScript engine. Okay, so of course, it is built on JavaScript platform. So anybody with JavaScript knowledge will find easy to learn Node.js as well. So now let's see how Node.js works. So in order to understand how Node.js works, you will have to first understand how backend works. Okay, so we just saw right now. Here, when I wanted the Facebook page, I got an output. And if this is in the third, usually any other language, say for example, ASP or PHP, when I'm getting this page, suppose you say Facebook page is not available on my server, it is on some third party server, but I'm going to continuously give few more inputs as well. I want these pages and all. So what happens is a traffic jam happens. Continuously giving loads will cause the traffic jam because I have not yet got my first output still. Okay, so why? Because only if this first output is got for me, only then it will move to the second part. And it, then it will see what else is this person looking out for and it gives me. So one after the other, you know, completion, after completion of one after the other process only, the next one goes on. So here, maybe I'll have to wait on my system till I get the request. So in Node.js, this is not there. When I continuously ask, and if there is any delay in any of the technical reason, okay, suppose I'm not getting Facebook name and it is in third party and there is time taking up to get me those page. So what happens is, suppose I'm giving few more requests, it will leave that part so that it is solved later whenever the image is got or whenever the related information of Facebook page name is got, it gives me. Until then, it is not going to sit idle. It will go to the next one and see what is that I'm looking for and it will try to fetch me those responses. So a user doesn't have to wait for anything in your Node.js. So this is the first and foremost reason why Node.js is successful in the market. So this is, first of all, saving the time of a developer as well as the client. Developer at developing stage and client when he's using the website. So now, what else do you want? So we have all this. You can get your, you have your request. You can send your request. You get back your response. Suppose there is no response, you don't have to wait. The elimination of waiting time is taken out here. Okay, the elimination, wait time is eliminated in Node.js. So the most beautiful part of Node.js is this, any backend. So none of the backend technology has this facility other than Node.js. Okay. Finally, so this is all about the front and backend. One language which is going to give us the information, it creates a way or path between the interaction between the front end and the backend. This service is taken care of by Node.js. That means a backend technology here, Node.js. Now, next part is, let's see what is MongoDB. Or to understand MongoDB, we'll first have to see what is database. So database is basically collection of data, storage of data, collection of any data. It can be pictures, it can be names, it can be a list of URLs, whatever. Just data stored is called as database. And it is not alone for storing, of course. If you would like to retrieve it later, you can retrieve it or take the information from the table whenever needed. So we have many database technologies, like maybe few of you would have been familiar with SQL, MySQL, Oracle, all this, and even MongoDB. So out of all this, MongoDB is standing out of the crowd. So why? Because it uses concept called as schema-less database. So wherein you don't have to worry about the table structure like you'll have to worry about in the SQL. So this is the first thing which makes MongoDB a favorite to everyone. Again, MongoDB is open source and anybody who would like to implement this can just log into this website and use this, okay? So MongoDB can be combined with backend languages like Python and Node.js to give you a proper database. So things are working like this. So first the presentation, how the website look, and next you will have to give the input or output or give the response, give the request and get the response. And this response, suppose if you wish to register on this page, your data will be stored, your data will be getting stored in database here, MongoDB.